Esteemed guests, my dear brothers and sisters, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Peace be upon all of you. It is indeed a great honor and a privilege for me to be with you tonight. To join you is such a precious moment. To share with you a moment that many generations to come will remember. To be honest with you, I am very much touched and impressed and overwhelmed with such a wonderful community. I did not come to visit here today for the last 30 years of my life. This is the second time after many years. And I can witness that growth and maturity and the youthful dedication and commitment. I know it has been a long day for all of you. You must be overwhelmed also and tired of your speeches and visions and all of that. But for me, I have a mission, and I have to share that with you. So please be patient and give me your attention for a few minutes. On behalf of this Islamic Society of North America, I would like to congratulate all of you for such a great achievement. The Muslim Community Center of the Islamic Center of Capital Districts. And in reality, today we are not only simply celebrating the grand opening of a beautiful physical facility, but indeed, and in reality, we are celebrating a story, a great story, a story of faith, a story of dedication, a story of success, a story of more than 3 decades of sincere devotion, sacrifices, and hard work, a story of community building that will contribute to the betterment of our American society at large. And I cannot help it with you to share with you that verse from the Quran that describing those people, men and women, who took upon themselves to establish the house of God and to establish the Muslim community. The verse from the Quran saying, في بيوت أذن الله أن ترفع ويذكر فيها اسمه يسبح له فيها بالغدو والآصال رجال لا تلهيهم تجارة ولا بيع عن ذكر الله وإقام الصلاة وإيتاء الزكاة يخافون يوما تتقلب فيه القلوب والأبصار ليجزيهم الله أحسن ما عملوا ويزيدهم من فضله والله يجزي من يشاء بغير حساب. Translation enhances which God has permitted to be raised and that his name shall be remembered in them. In them is he glorified in the mornings and in the evenings by men whom neither merchandise or nor selling can divert from the remembrance of Allah, God, nor from regular prayer, nor from the practice of regular charity. Their only fear is for the day when hearts and eyes be transformed, that Allah, God, the Almighty, may reward them according to the best of their deeds, and add even more for them out of His grace, for God does provide for those whom He will without mission. So I'd like to take this opportunity to congratulate them for an excellent job through sacrifice and contribution and building such a beautiful center for many generations to come. My dear brothers and sisters, today when I'm in the front of you, I can see you really a true manifestation of the true teachings of Islam, in spite of all the attack and the bigotry and Islamophobia. You are the true teachings of Islam. When God the Almighty says in the Quran, وَلْتَكُمْ مِنْكُمْ أُمَّةٌ يَدْعُونَ إِلَى الْخَيْرِ وَيَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَيَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ وَأُولَئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ. with their eyes out of view. A community inviting to all that's good, enjoying what is right and forbidding what's wrong, we are the ones to attain felicity. This is our Muslim community. This is our contribution to the society that we are living in. You are, my dear brothers and sisters, with your beautiful community, a beautiful example of what the verses of the Quran was describing and commanding. وَتَعَاوَنُوا عَلَى الْبِرِّ وَالتَّقْوَى وَلَا تَعَاوَنُوا عَلَى الْإِثْمِ وَالْعُدْوَانِ. Help one another in righteousness and piety, and do not help one another in sin and transgression. This is us. This is our mission. This is the beauty of our Islam and our Muslim community that are contributing to the betterment to our society for a much brighter future to come. I know we are truly going through a lot of change as Muslim community, as America at large. And we know that this kind of attack will not going to change the beautiful tradition and values of America. And I know that your presence tonight, in reality, is a true representation of the America's very favorite traditions and values, religious freedom and cultural diversity. My dear brothers and sisters, on behalf of you, the Islamic Society of North America decided not to be silent and to take a very strategic step and serious move. Alhamdulillah, with God's help, on Tuesday, September 7th, in the morning, we invited, on your behalf, the largest national religious organization in the nation, Christian, Jewish, and others. They came together at the National Press Club in the early morning, in Tuesday, 7th of September, 4 nights before the anniversary of tragedy of the 9/11. We came together with full commitment to face the challenging time that we are facing and combat all this attack. And I will share with you in 2 minutes, and then I conclude. I know I'm taking that much of your time, but that statement that came collectively from all these religious leaders that represents hundreds of thousands of churches and synagogues nationwide, and they represent millions of American Jews and American Christians from all walk of lives. They came together, and let me share with you a few words, because tonight again, with this interfaith alliance and beautiful coalition building, I'm very inspired to share that with you, and I will conclude with that. Religious leaders denounce anti-Muslim bigotry and call for respect for America's tradition of religious liberty. And now they continue, and they are saying, as religious leaders in this great country, we have come together in our nation's capital to denounce categorically the division, misinformation, and outside bigotry being directed to the American Muslim community. We bear a sacred responsibility to honor America's very fervent traditions and to promote a culture of mutual respect and assurance of religious freedom for all. In advance of the 9th anniversary of September 11th attack, we announced a new era of interfaith cooperation. Silence. Silence. Silence is not an option. This was the statement of that great coalition and leaders. And since that time, as tragedy would put, to go to the grassroots nationwide to address churches and synagogues and to create that kind of coalition to promote the beautiful culture and values of America. To conclude, as I started my verse from the Quran, I'd like to conclude that in spite of all that attack, and hate and prejudice. Our response to that is this verse from the Quran. وَلَا تَسْتَوِي الْحَسَنَةُ وَلَا السَّيِّئَةُ ادْفَعْ بِالَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنُ فَإِذَا الَّذِي بَيْنَكَ وَبَيْنَهُ عَدَاوَةٌ كَأَنَّهُ وَلِيٌّ حَمِيمٌ. Good and evil cannot be equal. Repair evil with something which is better. And verily, he between whom and yourself was enmity, made him become as though he had always been a close friend. This is our mission, this is our message. And once again, I was very much inspired by such a wonderful community. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless your efforts so you can continue growing such a beautiful project and be very much rooted and connected and become a part and parcel of the beauty of that mosaic of our religious and cultural diversity. To conclude, I'd like to take this opportunity to give a beautiful gift to my dear brother. This gift is actually the most recent translation of the Quran that took the translator more than 20 years with his team to finish it. It's the most recent, the most, using the current, most moderate American language. It's a beautiful gift, and this is the time when this. Thanks to bring the Quran, we are celebrating the Quran and I give it to him as a gift. Thank you very much. Assalamu alaikum.